Every year, millions of people in the U.S. have cosmetic procedures to erase those fine lines and wrinkles. Most of us are familiar with products like Botox and Juvederm, but what about using your own blood? Katie McGee takes a look at the latest trend in facial fillers.
30-something Lupe Ramos was noticing some subtle changes in her face.
I'm starting to get the frown lines and, you know, I call them the thinking marks. So I think I'm ready for a change.
What she wasn't ready for, injecting chemicals into her body.
I'm pretty much all about natural and organic, and why not try this? This is also the new phase of the vampires.
No, Lupe's not channeling Edward and Bella, but taking a page out of Twilight, she is turning to PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, a procedure that can rejuvenate your skin and fill those fine lines and wrinkles using your own blood.
The blood that we have in our bodies is a wealth of molecules and special proteins that are meant to be used in times of need to provide nutrients to the cells. So in order to access that fountain of youth, if you will, what we do is we remove just a couple little tubes of blood like you would if you were in the doctor's office.
Dr. Lisa ZDINAK says from there, the procedure's pretty simple. The blood is spun in a machine called a centrifuge, separating it into three layers.
And then the top layer is what we're interested in, and that's called the plasma. And in the plasma, there are special cells called platelets. And then by reintroducing the plasma portion into the skin, you're activating all of the skin cells that have been lying dormant for a while.
The plasma can be reintroduced in two ways. When used as a filler, Dr. Lisa mixes in a little something that changes it from a liquid into a more gelatinous texture to fill up the fine lines.
There's a little calcium chloride, it's a little sea salt, and that's what activates the platelets to release their growth factors. And then we get what's called a platelet-rich fibrin matrix, sort of like when you have jello gelatin.
The second treatment, which Dr. Lisa says is the more traditional use of PRP, is to inject the plasma in its natural state, just under the patient's skin, stimulating stem cells and reactivating your collagen naturally to give you a more youthful, plump look to the skin.
And what that does is it releases the growth factors and the platelet cells. You're waking up the cells that are there already and recruiting new cells to come to the area and make fresher, younger skin.
You can start to see a change immediately, and the skin continues to get smoother over time, with results lasting up to a year.
I feel great. I feel like I'm 18.
And PRP has been around for decades, used in everything from veterinary medicine to orthopedic procedures. But it'll cost you. Dr. Lisa says the average cost of a procedure ranges from $900 to $1,200, depending on how much blood they use.
I have a question. Mm-hmm. How long does it last?
Up to a year.
Up to a year. See, that is actually less expensive than Botox or Juvederm, because, you know, my brother's a dermatologist, and he says per area they charge you, you know, it can run anywhere from like $500 and up or whatever. So, I mean, that actually might be a little bit more cost effective.
It is, and it lasts a little bit longer. Botox usually doesn't tend to last as long.
Yeah.
So.
What about some like lotion from the drugstore, like some oil of Olay on your face instead of like $900 worth of...
Yourself
looking young.
Well, you can use, I mean, look, you definitely should moisturize. Everyone will tell you that.
Moisturize.
But we're all getting older, and sometimes you just can't stop, and some people have different genetics, and they just want to plump it up a little bit.
That's why they said beige don't age.
I never heard that.
Oh my gosh, my friend always tells me, she's like, black don't crack and beige don't age. So
look at what we learned.
You wouldn't believe how old she is.
I know, I am 62 tomorrow.
And so. White's a fright. What about now? See, when I had my full facelift, there was the recovery time. What about downtime after this procedure?
None. You can walk out.
You walk out.
Most of their redness was all gone by the time they left. By the time they left the office, you can go to the gym. You can go out for dinner. You can do whatever you want. It's nothing.
Right then and there.
Now, is it okay for anyone to do?
No, they will not do PRP on anybody taking blood thinners or anybody actively battling cancer.
Oh, well, makes sense. Okay.
All right. Thanks. Well, someone's battling something else. The mobile couch is going back in time to the 70s, and Alex Dennis is...